Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter 19, verses 25 to 27. But standing by the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. And Jesus, when he saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing near, he said to his mother, "Woman, behold your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Behold your mother." And from that hour, the disciple took her to his own home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters, at Bethlehem, Mary gave Jesus to us. At Calvary, Jesus gave his mother as our mother. At Bethlehem, Mary became the mother of Jesus. At Calvary, Mary became the mother of humanity. Mary was given a new role at Calvary. At Bethlehem, Mary was given the responsibility of bringing up Jesus. At Calvary, Mary was given a new role of bringing up the last person on the earth also to Jesus. Mary was given this role of bringing everyone to Jesus. Dear brothers and sisters, our Blessed Mother's memory days are very special to all of us because she is our mother. Jesus gave his mother as our mother. Today's gospel passage we heard Mary was standing at the foot of the cross in the last dying moments of Jesus. Many of our Protestant brothers and sisters of other denominations say Mary has other children. The simple fact, if Mary had other children, why did Jesus entrust Mary to St. John, his disciple? Mary is given as our mother. Mary has only one son, Jesus, and Jesus entrusted his mother as our mother. Look at that moment when Jesus gave his mother as our mother. That was a moment of Christ's excruciating pain. That was a moment he was dying on the cross in that pain. That is when he gave his mother as our mother. What does that say to us? When we were children, or even when we were growing up, when we had some pain, that is a moment we remember our mother. Yes, when we go through moments of agony, when we go through moments of pain, we have a mother whose prayer, whose help, whose hand you can hold on. She will come to help us. Today we are remembering the seven sorrows of our Blessed Mother. The seven sorrows of our Blessed Mother, we know first the prophecy of Simeon that a sword will pierce through your heart. When Mary was standing at the foot of the cross, that happened. She knew that sword was piercing, that prophecy was fulfilled there. Second, the flight to Egypt with baby Jesus, traveling with a baby in her hand, with fear of death, Mary fleeing to Egypt, the second sorrow of Mary. The third sorrow of Mary is missing child Jesus in the temple, a mother's pain of missing her son, searching for Jesus, third sorrow. The fourth sorrow of Mary is meeting Jesus on the way to Calvary, seeing her son carrying the cross. Again, that moment Mary experienced the tremendous pain in her heart. Fifth sorrow of Mary is the moment of Christ's crucifixion. She saw Jesus being cruelly nailed to the cross, the moment of crucifixion. The sixth sorrow of Mary is bringing down the dead body of Jesus from the cross. And the seventh sorrow of Mary is the burial of Jesus. Dear brothers and sisters, what are they saying to all of us? Mary joined her sorrows with the pain of Christ, and thus she plays a role in our own salvation. Let us also offer all our pain through the hands of Mary to Jesus. We can waste our sufferings, or we can make our sufferings into a virtue. Mary shows, make sufferings into virtue. Make sufferings into prayers. When we are able to offer our sufferings, our agony, our sickness, along with Mary, along with Jesus, it becomes a virtue. We bring down the graces of God into our family, into our community. When Jesus was with Mary in the wedding at Cana, Jesus said to Mary, "My hour has not come." Today, when Mary was standing at the foot of the cross, Mary knew her son's hour has come. She saw her son's suffering, and she silently stood there, joining with Christ, joining in Christ's pain. That was Mary, that role Mary did. We are also asked at times to stand with Mary at the foot of the cross. Let us learn from Mary to make our suffering into virtues. The gospel passage concludes this way. John, the beloved disciple, took Mary home. How beautiful. How beautiful an imagery is that. Let us also take Mary home. When Mary is with us, we know she will help us in our moments of struggle. Her presence will be the great refuge that we can have in our life, in our moments of sufferings. Let us make a small prayer. Lord Jesus, we thank you for the gift of your mother as our mother. Very especially on this day, as we remember our Blessed Mother's sorrows. Through her intercession we pray that we may be able to make our suffering into virtues, that we may be able to offer up our sufferings at the foot of the cross for the salvation of the world, for the salvation of our own families, for the salvation of people who are dear and near to us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.